President Yoweri Museveni last week appointed Janet Mugabe-Anyine as the new first-ever female deputy director general of the External Security Organization. The position of the deputy director general has for long been vacant after the departure of Emmanuel Ewaku in 2009. Ewaku is currently the director of investment at Operation Wealth Creation under the office of the president. Anyine holds a bachelor's degree in statistics from Makerere University and a master's degree in global security and strategies from the School of African Oriental Studies at the University of London, UK. Prior to the new appointment, Anyine has been in charge of special duties in the Office of the President and a former aspirant for the Kiruhura District Member of Parliament seat in 2016. She was also working with the Public Opinion, an entity working towards attaining Vision 2040. Anyine will be working with the ISO Director General, Ambassador Joseph Ochwet, and their major role is to thwart emerging external threats to Uganda. She'll also be in charge of presenting security reports to the Joint Security Committee. Medics at Masaka Hospital are stuck with patients with no personal documents. Among them is a 12-year-old girl with speech impairment who is believed to have been admitted by Red Cross volunteers when she was involved in an accident that left one of her legs broken. The officials say little is known of the patient and that since she was admitted, no relative has come to visit her.
Omuwala awunyaka nga 12 yaletebwa bana ba Red Cross bamwita mutwalo genaku z'omwezi 2 ogw'omukaaga onokusa kati tulabanga ku bantu bamugoberera naye bamujjajja afunye accident.
Other patients include Abdul Mutangizi, who got a brain damage during an accident. A 60-year-old woman identified as Grace Nabayinda and Wanda Tijuka were also under treatment, but medics say they have failed to trace their relatives. The medics in charge of the patients, Tony Mawanda and Sister Mary Namsambaga, have asked the public if they have any information about these patients to avail it to the hospital or inform their relatives. An alliance of French left-wing parties was on course yesterday to beat the far-right and President Emmanuel Macron's coalition in a stunning outcome to parliamentary elections that plunged France into a new political uncertainty. No one group won an absolute majority in the second round of the poll, which leaves France without any clear path to forming a new government 3 weeks before the Paris Olympics.
C'est la victoire d'une droite claire et indépendante. Je pense aussi évidemment à tous les candidats de ma famille politique, qui sont restés droits contre toutes les manœuvres. On ne perd jamais à rester fidèle à ses convictions. Mais je mesure aussi à quel point les Français, après ces résultats, sont inquiets pour l'avenir et redoutent d'être une fois de plus floués après les élections. Je veux donc leur dire avec la plus grande clarté ce que sera notre position.
But after winning the June 30th first round by a clear margin, the results were a major disappointment for the far-right national rally of Marine Le Pen, even if her forces are said to boast about the biggest ever contingent in parliament. Macron's centric alliance will have dozens fewer members of parliament, but held up better than expected. Prime Minister Gabriel Attal said he would offer Macron his resignation today, but was ready to serve as long as duty demands, notably in light of the imminent games.
Je sais qu'à la lumière des résultats de ce soir, bon nombre de Français ressentent une forme d'incertitude sur l'avenir, puisqu'aucune majorité absolue ne se dégage. Notre pays connaît une situation politique sans précédent et se prépare à accueillir le monde dans quelques semaines. Aussi, j'assumerai bien évidemment mes fonctions aussi longtemps que le devoir l'exigera. Il ne peut en être autrement à la veille d'échéance si un.
But projections by major polling agencies showed the NFP set to be the largest bloc in the new National Assembly, with 177 to 198 seats. Macron's alliance on 152 to 169 seats and the RN on 135 to 145 seats. This means no group is even close to the 289 seats needed for an absolute majority, and it remains unclear how a new government can be formed. Macron, who has yet to speak in the public about the projections, is calling for prudence and analysis of the results, said an aide asking not to be named.